See, he has been in the cabinet for long. Now, this kind of a statement arising from him is, of course, a matter of shame for us. There is no doubt about it. And we are asking for apology with a folded hands. Now, second thing, what you have been pointing right away and again, that no ministers were there on the cremation. You were wrong in that. All the ministers were there on the cremation. You can check it the fact with the BJP also. Because
I said your chief minister was not there, he did not visit the families who died. I was absolutely right.
My chief minister, yes. Let me come on that also. You were right. The body came here yesterday in the evening. And the
anyway,
chief
don't
minister
try
was
to
there
change
in
the subject.
With a prefix assignment.
No, don't try to make a weak attempt to change the subject.
And other in the planning committee.
I asked you a question. Don't set the question for yourself, Ajay.
I'm not trying to change the subject.
You do not have the luxury of deciding what you want to answer. The question is this. Arnav, this man has not apologized. He has said my comments were twisted. Your chief minister has not sacked him. And that's the only question tonight. Are you not embarrassed to have such a man on a state cabinet? That is the only question,
the
and you have no answer. So I'm moving on to Manoj Jha.
You are embarrassed for his statement.
Arnav, can I come in here?
Manoj.
Yeah,
yes, Manoj.
In fact, it is indeed saddening to note that on a day of such traumatic memory, we are discussing the distastefully bizarre comment from a minister and who is in the habit of doing so. But I would say that his apology is not unqualified. By adding qualifier, he has further disturbed the rhythm of the disturbed psyche, not only in Bihar, the families of the martyr, but all over the nation. Number one. Number two, it is very important to also underline that this government is in the habit of failing completely in dealing with crisis. Bodh Gaya, Chhat, every time.
This is a political statement.
Know how to handle.
No,
fact,
this is a political statement.
In fact, I would call this.
This is what I'm talking. They are politicizing everything. Don't politicize this. Mr. Man.
I'm not.
I would like to remind you that Mr. Lalu Prasad Yadav had called Mr. Sharma a nice man.
Did I intervene, Mr. Alok? Did I intervene?
Was he not responsible for Kargil?
Did I?
No, but what you're saying is wrong facts, so I have to intervene.
Please don't
I'm
do
not
that.
Here to listen to you. When you don't, speak wrong,
don't
when you speak wrong, I cannot.
Don't disturb. Don't disturb a national level
Ajay,
debate
you know, Ajay,
by these kind of harangues.
No, one second, Ajay. Ajay, if you want to say tonight, I'm going to intervene here at this stage. If you want to say tonight, allow me to complete, Ajay. If you want to say tonight, we are not sorry.
Okay.
We are not sorry enough to sack him. I want you and KC Tyagi to say on national television tonight, we are not sorry enough to sack Bhim Singh. You say tonight that Nitish Kumar
They can never sack Bhim Singh. Because this entire government is concerned only about carrying the government. Not about what has been done to the families of the martyrs or to their memory.
Now, if I speak on this, then he will say I'm interfering on him. No, this cannot go.
You did.
Go ahead.
You did interfere.
What has
can you not believe that your bill?
I first want to say this. No, one second, Mr. Ajay Alok. I want to say this, Mr. Ajay Alok. I will not allow politics over this. I will not allow you to go political over this.
True.
You did this.
So
he did that.
What is happening?
NDA did this.
What
UPA did that.
RJD
did this. JDU did that. Do the people of this country care which political party did what? What the people of this country care is only one thing, that there is a politician, a minister in a state government who has said that the martyrs of this country can be bought. That's what he has said, hasn't he, Rita Bahuguna Joshi? He is saying ki shahadat jo hoti hai, uski keemat hoti hai. Aap mujhe bataiye aaj ki shahadat ki keemat kya hai? Aap politicize mat kijiye KC Tyagi ji. आप बताइए देश को कि शहादत की कीमत क्या है आपके अनुसार और जिस व्यक्ति ने यह बात कही उसको आप निलंबित क्यों नहीं करते उसको सैक क्यों नहीं करते अपने सरकार से
ऐसा है लोकतंत्र
वो ऐसा कभी नहीं कर सकते
अपनी
उनकी सरकार गिर जाएगी वो सरकार बचाने की चिंता ज्यादा है
किसी को बोलने देंगे कि नहीं बोलने देंगे आप
नहीं कहिए मगर पॉलिटिसाइज मत कीजिए बीजेपी भी पॉलिटिसाइज ना कीजिए आरजेडी आल्सो डोंट पॉलिटिसाइज दिस यस
नहीं मैं इसको राजनीति से दूर करके कहना चाहता हूं हमारे मुख्यमंत्री ने माफी मांगी है हम आपके सामने समूचे देश से माफी मांग रहे हैं और एज ए गांधीयन आई एम ऑन रिकॉर्ड ऑन सेइंग कि गलती करने के बाद अगर कोई प्रायश्चित करता है तो उसकी गलती माफ होती है। ये कोई तरीका है जिस तरह से कह रहे हैं बोधगया में क्या हुआ था?
सकता हूं
चीफ
सुधांशु त्रिवेदी, सुधांशु त्रिवेदी ऑफ द बीजेपी, ठीक है आप फिर आप दूसरी तरफ से सुन लीजिए सुधांशु त्रिवेदी प्लीज विदाउट पॉलिटिसाइजिंग मिस्टर बख्शी बीजेपी देखा नहीं है जिसमें एक्शन हम नहीं लेंगे और फिर हम गांधीयन वैल्यूज के पीछे छिप जाएंगे, ये कोई गांधीयन वैल्यू नहीं है। सुधांशु त्रिवेदी,
I would like to say that the minister who is trying to put the sacrifice of soldiers as a matter of salaried compensation, it's like saying, I would like to remember a sentence of a 20 years old movie in which he says ki chand paison ke liye apne kalam ki siyahi bahane se bahut mushkil hai apne badan ka lahu bahana. There is no comparison of that. And my second question, second pretension is there is a tendency in the entire political leadership. It's not a question of JDU alone. If you look at a very senior leader of Congress party, though Ms. Rita Baghuna Joshi has expressed a feeling of it, but the other leader of the Congress party who feel pleasure in going to the places and villages of those who are direct terror suspects, but they never got an opportunity to visit the villages of the soldiers who were beheaded. The senior leaders of the Congress party who used the phrase Osama G, but they never visited the soldiers who have been beheaded. This is a tendency which has been consistently, you can say, apathetic towards those who are setting down their lives because they are not the vote bank. And my objection is to this tendency that the entire JDU government was sleeping in the night when those soldiers were there.
We have 5 minutes left on this debate. I think it's we give the opportunity for the Congress to respond. And after that, once more, for the third time on this News Hour debate, I will ask the JDU representatives whether they will go with their view and whether they will say on national television that this man should be sacked. But before that, Rita Baghuna Joshi, yes, we remember that many other martyrdoms, including the martyrdom of Delhi policeman Mohanchand Sharma in the Batla House encounter, was also Sharma. Questioned by certain Congress leaders. Please respond to the BJP.
And moreover, they have sent a 26-year-old
on honored martyrs. They have always been there. And our view on Sharma's assassination, his death, is very clear to the nation, the party's view. As far as the martyrs are concerned, we've always been there. I want to ask Mr. Sudhanshu Mittal ji. Today, the defense minister was giving a statement in the house. Most of the ministers were there. Which minister, except this Bihar minister of theirs, a leader, went to Bihar? Did the president go? Did anybody else go? The question is not there. The question was 600 soldiers died because of the mishandling of the Kargil war. Because when the BJP government was in power, how many places did they go? They were hiding in their homes. Congress never hides. We always respect our martyrs. We have always put that way because we have also have martyrs in our own party. We have 3 martyrs in the Congress party ever since the independence. We have given up life and blood for the nation. They don't have to teach us patriotism. They don't have to teach us what martyrdom is. The entire independence movement is the history of martyrdom.
I would like to respond to Rita. I'm extending this, Rita Baghuna Joshi, with great respect to you and to Sudhanshu Trivedi. I request you, with great respect to both of you,
I would like to
I will not let this become a political fight. There are some issues on which there should be political fights. This is not one of them. This is not one of them. As I said, I will give one more opportunity on the news tonight.
Any opportunity to visit that village?
So please don't tell us story. And
I am asking
very sad
that don't also
individual martyrdom who have caused for jingoism. Martyrdom of our great soldiers should not be a cause for jingoist politics.
His apology is not enough. And the chief minister should take a strong action against him. This is not the way a minister can talk about a martyr.
Okay, now if you
I
finish,
heard his entire...
If you finish, if you finish, jo JDU ke representative hai is program mein, the JDU representatives on the program, wo kehte hain, ki Gandhi ke philosophy ko dekhte hue, Rita Baghuna Joshi ji, aap kyun nahi kehti aaj? Rita Baghuna Joshi ji, why don't you say that we will not do business ever with Nitish Kumar? We will not have a strategic alliance with Nitish Kumar. We will not deal with Nitish Kumar if he doesn't sack this minister. You won't say that.
This issue,
because you also put politics first.
Please, this issue.
So what you're doing is lip service.
This issue is between the chief minister and his minister. This issue is, and we are not doing any business with him. This issue is between the chief minister and a minister who is a member of his cabinet.
No, no, it's not. You are again passing the buck.
And he's unpardonable.
No, you're passing the buck. You can put the pressure on your own.
I mean, you, please.
No, you can take, you can put the pressure on your own. The question tonight is this, ki some of our leaders say G.D. Bakshi and Colonel Anil Kaul. Jo JDU ke representatives hai, wo keh rahe hai, G.D. Bakshi and Colonel Anil Kaul ki maaf kar dijiye. Action nahi lenge, magar maaf kar dijiye. Hame to lagta hai ki kai galtiyan aisi hoti hai jiski maafi nahi hoti. Aapko kya lagta hai? What do you think, Colonel Anil Kaul and G.D. Bakshi? Colonel Kaul.
Mera isme sirf ek hi इल्तजा है, रिक्वेस्ट है इन महानुभावों से जो कि स्क्रीन पे दिखाए जा रहे हैं, हर एक पार्टी के नुमाइंदे, कि हमारी फौज और मैं उसका एक जीता जागता एग्जाम्पल हूं जिसने इस देश के लिए खून बहाया है. और मेरे को मिलने के लिए एक बहुत दिग्गज नेता आए थे, दो सेब और दो मौसम्बियां लेकर. तो मेरी रिक्वेस्ट आपसे ये है कि हम हमारे शहीदों को, हमारे मार्टियर्स को अपनी गंदी पॉलिटिक्स में से बाहर रहने दें. एक दूसरे के ऊपर जो ब्राउनी पॉइंट्स आप करते हैं उनको छोड़ दें. और ये माफी लायक गलती नहीं है.
माफी लायक गलती नहीं है. अजय आलोक एंड केसी त्यागी, आई सेड आई विल गिव यू वन मोर ऑप्शन बिफोर आई गो टू जी डी बख्शी. G.D. Bakshi, should we hear from the two politicians first before I give you the closing remarks? Let's hear from them. Once again and for the last time on the News Hour tonight, Ajay Alok and K.C. Tyagi, the ball is in your court. Do you think Nitish Kumar should sack Bhim Singh tomorrow? Or do you think Nitish Kumar should take on the country's anger and say the country may be angry, but I'm not going to do anything to this man? The ball is in your court one last time.
I mean, are we sitting here for some kind of a speculation? Are we speculating on certain things?
I'm asking you a question.
These are administrative affairs.
I'm asking you a question.
Let the decision come.
What's the speculation?
Why are you speculating that Nitish Kumar is going to do this, Nitish Kumar is going to do that?
I'm not speculating anything. I'm asking you for your view.
What we have done, we have tendered the apology. And we are still tendering the apology with the folded hand. That yes,
or does being a politician mean that you should not have any view?
My God, he's being impertinent. This is impertinence at the highest level. And on national television, just because you are a politician doesn't give you the authority to be impertinent.
What your vote will be, my view, when I'm ashamed of the comments made.
Where is the question of
contrition?
You are not ruling this country, my dear. You are there because we have put you there.
Can I comment?
Yes, General Bakshi.
Can I comment, please? Arnab, I'd like to tell them that real contrition would be if that gentleman walked up to the families of those soldiers of the Bihar regiment who have just been cremated, right? And asked them,
Absolutely.
Wife for forgiveness.
He will do that. The CM will make sure that he does that.
I have my doubts here, the guts will even go there.
Politicians for sheer political survival are capable of doing anything.
Mr. Nitish Kumar does not have the guts to ask Mr. Bhim Singh to do so.
Mr. Bhim Singh doesn't have the guts to go to the families as suggested by General Bakshi.
When the question will be,
K.C. Tyagi hits up the issue.
K.C. Tyagi, the question will be, does Nitish Kumar have the guts to sack the minister? Or does Nitish Kumar have the guts to face the entire nation and say, no, I need the minister, the nation be damned?
I agree.
Feelings be damned.
Mr. Bakshi's suggestion. Hello?
GG.
That Mr. Bhim Singh must tender his unconditional apology to the family of the martyr. Sacking or no sacking,
you want an
is
easy
the prerogative
route
of the chief minister.
You want an easy escape route. That's not all what G.D. Bakshi said. G.D. Bakshi also thinks he should voluntarily resign. Don't you think, Mr. Bakshi? Isn't that what you said? What K.C. Tyagi is saying is that one more statement tomorrow as a desperate attempt to keep his job. That I'm sorry. Can I get on with it? That's what K.C. Tyagi is saying. But that's not what you're saying, are you, G.D. Bakshi?
If there was any sense, an iota of shame, you would have flung in that resignation about 8 hours back. 8 hours back. And you know, Arnab, it is our fault. We deserve the government that we get. I'm sorry. We are equally to blame. We elected him. We put him where he is. We put them where they are. So that they can add insult to injury when the boys die.
General Bakshi.
When the women are crying.
Yes, General
Bakshi.
When
the children are weeping.
It is because we elected him that we also reserve the right to ask him to resign. After that, it's upon his conscience and Nitish Kumar's conscience.
Absolutely.
And we won't let go of this story. We'll follow it tomorrow.
The right to recall.
Thank you, ladies and gentlemen, for joining me on that debate. Thank you very much indeed. Thank you.